Hey, Phoenix, how are you? We have a long tradition at Bolts Middle School of recognizing students who have made an impression, not only on their peers, but on the entire staff during their time at Bolts. The Phoenix Award is meant to acknowledge those students who have consistently shown excellence in scholarship, leadership, and citizenship. The selection of award winners begins with the entire staff providing names of possible recipients to our 8th grade team. That list appears in your program. From there, our 8th grade team narrows that list to the students receiving the award. In a moment, you will hear a snapshot about each Phoenix Award winner from a member of our staff. Sit back, enjoy, and remember all the times you had here at Bolts, as this is the end of your 8th grade year and your chance to move forward. We will miss all of you. We appreciate all of you. We wish this year could have been different. Obviously, it is what it ended up being. But know that you're cared about and loved here at Bolts, and you're always welcome to come back and say hello. So without further ado, the Phoenix Award winners.
Hi there. What would be the slate of talents needed in the future? What are those 21st century skills so often identified as critical for success? What are the early markers of leadership? Have they really changed? Be yourself is the mantra seldom followed, as many fall in line with what is trending. What we have come to realize is that being true to oneself is the genesis of freedom from popular culture. And it is likely the basis of joy that emanates from this young Phoenix every day and in every class. The German teacher uses this description: the most enthusiastic student she has ever taught, and especially when announcing what the daily snack is. In perfect German, of course. Bantering with classmates is a favorite pastime, but it is also a glimpse into the self-confidence it takes to laugh at your own ways and actions. Many will think back to their time as a teen and those students who just seemed comfortable in their own skin. This liberating trait is what allows him to take risks. What is remarkable is that the others gain traction off this student's willingness to try something that stretches their own perceived capabilities. That is leadership. Some might say that those with high marks are just naturally intelligent. But the teachers know that every point earned by this student is through hard work and perseverance. That's the scholarship piece to this award. He is genuine, unwavering, and wants only what is good for everyone. His classmates and teammates recognize this in him and see that he is a rising star that will continue to shine brightly in all that he pursues. Again, there's been much debate about the skill set necessary to navigate the waters of the future. The truth of the matter is, the qualities possessed by this Phoenix Award recipient have stood the test of time. Congratulations to you, Jaden Putman. Thank you.
Good morning. Earning the Phoenix Pride Award is a high honor. Academic excellence is part of the equation. Imagine a student who arrives 10 to 15 minutes before first period every day, takes her seat, and continues reading what is very likely her second or third book she will finish this week. While reading may at this point be second nature, she holds herself to that same level of excellence across all of her subjects and levels of difficulty, and has for 3 years here at Bolts. That consistency is also part of why students are recognized as Phoenix Pride. For 3 years, through a pandemic, online or in person, hybrid or quarantined, I knew, and all of our teachers knew, that having this student in class would be a pleasure and make school a better place for all of her peers. The way she treats others, for me, is probably the biggest reason I support her selection for Phoenix Pride. Besides observing how she treats students and teachers equally with kindness, her leadership abilities really shine when she works with her classmates. She doesn't allow members to be left out. She leads the team toward excellence, while at the same time exerting a quiet insistence that the educational value of the project and its product are both functions of how well the team works together. That isn't to say she can't be spirited. I think what sets a Phoenix Pride student apart from other excellent students may be that particular spark and sense of humor the student brings to the academic world. This particular student may put down the aforementioned book just as class begins to insist we watch a movie every day for months now. But who doesn't love a sense of humor? But that's what it takes to earn the Phoenix Pride Award, and you have them all in spades. But what does it mean that you have what it takes? No matter what this world throws at you, you're developing the habits and skills that will carry you to whatever you dream your future to be. We are happy for you and proud of you, thankful for you and hopeful for you. Wherever you go, the world will be a better place because of you. Congratulations, Ivy Halubar.
There are people who will come into our lives that we appreciate immediately and forever. The person I would like to honor today is one of those students. This student likes to run long distances, and as I reflect on this year that has been like no other, I can't imagine a more perfect metaphor than to compare his journey this year to a marathon. He decided early on that he was in it for the long haul. He was not looking to get ahead quick or finish first. He was careful not to race ahead of the pack and run out of steam. He understands that great things take time and effort, and he was willing to put in the work. He is self-aware. He decides what he wants to change or work on and is persistent in working towards his goals. His work ethic is unmatched. He offers a perspective on literature and on life that is well beyond his years, often encouraging his classmates and me to shift our own perspectives and consider things in a different way. He is inclusive of everyone. It doesn't matter if he's working with a close friend or someone he rarely interacts with, he believes everyone is worthy of care and respect. It is my belief that the way we create positive social change is through the little ways we take care of each other every day. And this kid is changing things. Leader, student athlete, peer mentor, novelist, yes, he is all of these things. But what I appreciate most about him is his kind soul and heart of gold. Bolts will be a little less bright without you, Brecken, but I can't wait to see what waits for you on the road ahead. So for all of these reasons, you, Brecken Bort, are a Phoenix Award winner. Congratulations.
Our next award goes out to an outstanding young woman who epitomizes what the Phoenix Award is all about. Even during a pandemic, she has excelled in academics, character, and leadership this school year. Academically, she always challenges herself to be the best she can be. She enjoys learning and the satisfaction that comes from a job well done, but also appreciates the learning process and the mistakes she makes along the way. Not only does she take the time to be successful in all of her classes, she is never too busy to help a peer in need. She takes time to express gratitude to those who she is thankful for. She is a positive light wherever she goes and makes everyone feel special and loved. In her role as a web leader this year, she has formed connections and made an incredible culture for her weblets that I know they will remember forever. Lastly, she has made my days happier and brighter this year, which means more to me than I can ever express in words. I am beyond honored to present this Phoenix Award to Miss Angela Olson. I love you. I can't think of anyone who deserves this award more than you. Mwah.
Good morning, Bolts 8th graders. Bucksman here, and I have the honor to tell you about one of our Phoenix Award recipients. I've had the pleasure of getting to know the student this year in science, and I can easily say that this student is one of the most positive and inclusive students that I've ever met in my time as a teacher. From the first day of class and remote learning, the student was quick to start each session with a "Good morning, everyone," and the rest of the class. When we finally got to meet in person this year, the student would enter the room with a smile and a warm greeting for everyone around. Regardless of what we're studying, the student asked and answered questions and offered to help other students when he was done doing his work. To get some insight from others, I reached out to the student's teachers and heard nothing but super positive things. One teacher told me, "When I think of this student, I think of someone who genuinely wants to learn. The student is genuinely a kind and wonderful person who is always willing to give others in the class a little pep talk." Another teacher told me, "My favorite thing about this student is the student's warm and friendly personality. Often I'll ask my class how they do and how are they doing, but this student genuinely wants to know how I'm doing as well. This student is one of the kindest students I've ever met. When we were meeting online, the student would often just turn on the camera just to make me smile." Finally, I thought I would just go to the student to get even more insight. So I asked this student, "What do you think it takes to be a successful eighth grader at Bolts?" He thought about it, he smiled, and he told me, "It's important to be great. To be a great student, be a great person, and be a great friend." And honestly, I think that about sums it up for this student. It's pretty apparent from interviewing his teachers, getting to know him, that he follows this credo of just simply being a great person. Aiden Wood, thank you for being such a positive force at Bolts. Thank you for being inclusive and willing to help others. Thank you for your positive pep talks to your peers. Thank you for being such a great person. Congratulations, Aiden. You truly deserve the Phoenix Award for this school year.
I am pleased to present this Phoenix Award to a student who can best be described as courageous. From the moment this student walked in the door as a sixth grader, her behavior choices have been noticed by Bolts staff. One teacher remembers how at Camp Timberline she set aside her own fears to support and encourage her classmates to do their best. This student's blooming leadership skills did not stop there, but have developed in the classroom as well. She has shown courage by leading conversations among her peers in cooperative learning groups. She was especially helpful to staff with her willingness to lead and participate during online learning. She models courage by displaying vulnerability when asking questions in class and making others feel comfortable to ask their own. She does not hesitate to help other students and does so with kindness. She is always prepared to play her part in orchestra class. She emerged as a section leader early in sixth grade and has continued through eighth grade into chamber orchestra. Her classroom teachers comment on her intense attention to detail, her insightful writing responses, and her focus and deliberation on her learning. She is also humble and self-sufficient. This student is a beloved web leader and will be missed by the staff and her weblets. We will miss her kind smile and daily greetings, for which we want to say thank you. Those small gestures are greatly appreciated. To quote J.K. Rowling from Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets, it is our choices that show what we truly are, far more than our abilities. This Phoenix Award winner has chosen integrity at all times, and that takes great courage indeed. Please join me in congratulating Michaela Veneman as a 2021 Phoenix Award winner.
Get my her right. All right, let's go.